Hello everyone, Deo here. I'm just gonna share my opinion on our Philippine shoutcasters in LoL Esports. As for my background, I watch NA and EU LCS every week, and sometimes the LCK. But I never watch any LoL PH Pro games, so I started last week and here's my opinion on the PH shoutcasters. For the pick and ban phase, they talk about the basic skills of the champion and what they can provide for the team. Then they talk about the player's known build to their champion, which is very good. They have an idea how a player plays on this champion. Those kinds of details will make the pick and ban phase interesting. As for the lane matchups, which is very important if you want to improve at League of Legends, they have an idea but not in depth, like the counter plays or how they should play in that matchup or what path build they should take. What I notice is that they don't talk about in details are the team compositions. Sometimes they do, but they were just stating the obvious. For example, a team has picked Corki and Kog, they're going for a poke-oriented team comp. But what about the other three champions? What are their power spikes? When are they strong? Early to mid? Mid to late? What are your predictions when a team comp starts to clash? Are they going for a flank or an all-in clash? As for the level 1, this is where the players go for an invade or just place down their wards for information if the enemy team is going for a lane swap or where the enemy jungler might start. But instead of talking about that, the shoutcasters were discussing the general love life in the Philippines. It is fine to add a little humor, and that is most of the NA shoutcasters do, but they connect their humor to the game. So even if they talk about the boring level 1, they kept it alive by adding a little humor related to the level 1. But that was just from one game, and for the other games, they do talk about the level 1. As for the 2v1 lane swaps, they know the advantages and disadvantages of it, which is very nice to know. Next, they talk about how good the ganks and rotations made by a team, but they don't analyze what went wrong on the opposite team. Why did the gank work? Was it because the lack of vision or no proper communication in the team? I think they should also talk about the mistakes made by the team. Now, they talk about ward coverage, and they just state the obvious. Blue team warded heavily on red team's bottom jungle. They don't talk about the placement of the pink wards. In warding, you can tell if the team is going for a defensive or offensive playstyle, an early dragon, or going for a pick at an objective. As for the post-game analysis, they talk about the statistics and builds of the team. I wish they would show some highlights of the game and analyze it to see the macro and micro levels made by the player. And what I love about our shoutcasters is that they know how to keep the game alive, even during its low moments. They will talk about a certain topic until something interesting happens in the game. All of these details, even the small ones, can help improve the player and the people who are watching. If the players learn, they get better at the game, and the game becomes more entertaining to watch, and that can lead to more viewers. And feel free to comment below your opinions on the esports scene in the Philippines. These are just my opinions, and I hope this can help improve the esports scene in the Philippines. Thanks for watching.